the drama continues, man. The drama continues with UFC 226. Paul Felder is getting a fight. 10 days notice. He's getting a fight. He's moving up to 170 welterweight to beat the shit out of Mike Perry. Wow. And this is exactly what I said in my last video. The thing is, I recorded those videos and I scheduled them to come out. But by the time they came out, he already had a fight. But I just let him go and come out anyways because I enjoyed the rant and I thought it was pretty good. So I put the work in. Why not put the video out? But in those last videos, what did I say? I said, Mike Perry, he's in trouble now. You know, when Yancy Medeiros pulled out, I said, Mike Perry is about to get a killer. I think that he's about to get a killer. That's what I said in the last video. I said, he's in trouble. And they pulled up the fucking sniper. Paul Felder is just this sniper. He comes off as very, you know, especially now that he's doing commentary, Paul Felder's just a likable guy. He comes off as very likable. He's like a, you know, he looks like one of those characters from Whoville. You know, the coolest who in Whoville. But he's likable. He's really smart with the fight game. Like, once I heard him do his first, you know, debut, his first commentary gig, I can't remember which one it was. It made me realize how good of a fight. I was like, this guy's a good fighter. Like, he's an incredibly smart fighter. He's brutal, no doubt about it. He's brutal. He is clipping you up with several elbows and several knees. But he's a really smart fighter, and I actually really like the guy. I think that he thinks he should be higher in the rankings. I think he should be higher in the rankings. The problem is, I said what the problem was in the last video, and I still stand by that. But right now, you know, I don't know what this win is going to do for him, because he's definitely getting a win. There is no way Mike Perry has any tools for Muay Thai. There is absolutely no way that he has any tools for Muay Thai. That Muay Thai style is very difficult. It's one of my favorite styles to see in the octagon. You know, if a person comes out Muay Thai, you can very easily make a fan out of me. But I don't know. I know that he's finally moved. Mike Perry finally moved to a real camp in the Winklejohn camp, but he's going to need a little bit more time to cook. Mike Perry, he's too young. He's too young and too stupid. He is literally like a bag of rocks. There's no entertainment in it unless maybe, you know, there's just nothing. He only appeals to the lowest common denominator. And it's just, Mike Perry is just a dumb guy. He really is. But he's also young. A lot of people, when they're young, they're dumb. I give the guy the benefit of the doubt that he's making changes. He's growing up. He's out here trying to find wisdom and not just trying to live in his own stupidity. But he's not afraid, though. He said, hey, let's go, motherfucker. Let's go. He said, let's go. He did not shy away from the matchup, which is great. And I'm glad that Paul Felder is getting this. Whenever you step up like this, he's stepping up 10 days notice. Stepping up to fight. Now, he's already in a camp, which is cool. I know he's already in a camp. You know, the good thing is that he won't have to cut weight for this. Or maybe he will. I don't know what he walks around at, but he definitely won't have to cut to 155, which might be, you know, which is going to be a lot easier for him. So I'm really excited to see Felder stepping up, stepping in there, getting this fight. He should get a highlight reel knockout. He really should get an absolute highlight reel knockout. He should lift Mike Perry up off of his feet and send him to the canvas bloody. That's my prediction. That is my prediction. And speaking of predictions, I'm going to do a fight prediction for every single fight on this UFC 226 card. It is absolutely stacked. I'm going to give it a couple of days before I start getting into it, just in case anything else falls out. But it is an absolutely stacked card, and I'm going to go ahead. I'm going all in with the UFC. I'm going to get pumped. You know, the stacked cards, they know how to fall apart. They really know how to fall apart, but I'm going to go ahead and get pumped again. I'm going to go ahead and put my back into it and kind of, you know, get back in the mood. Because this is just, we're literally at the brink of greatness. We're literally at the brink of greatness, man. So I'm excited about it. I've got coming up next for Channel MMA is basically going to be the fight, pre-fight analysis and pre-fight predictions. And then there's going to be a what's next for Tatiana Suarez. Tatiana Suarez is, no doubt about it, the next future champion in the women's strawweight division. And what else is coming up next? A bunch of UFC 226 stuff. So you guys, you know, thank you all who have gone ahead and hit that subscribe button early in the game. We don't have a whole lot of subscribers. I think we're about a month into the channel, or 3 weeks into the channel. I've been having a good time doing it, having a lot of fun. So thanks, guys, for hitting the subscribe button, hitting the like button, and sending me a couple comments every once in a while. Really appreciate it.